Alrighty, we're back. We got round number three about to begin here in a moment or two. Let me flip this back on over. At the moment, Jim's actually still AFK, if I'm not mistaken, so hang tight for a second or two. Nice pass. Want to say hi to everybody? Oh, where's my camera? Aha! So while we have a chance here, because I can still see Jim's in the background. Oh, look who wanted to say hi. He's going to get all set up here really quick, but Spaz wants to say hi to everybody. Oh, hi. Hi, Spaz. We're here for round three. Boom, Spaz love. And I may or may not be wearing my man shirt. Just saying. So Spaz loves everybody. Let me get this flip back over in a second or two here. How you doing? Spaz love. Tell everyone hi. Yeah, that's right. All right, you want to watch round three, bud? Yeah, you want to tell everybody you love them. All right, let's watch round three. Hi, everybody. So we're back. We got round number three just about to start here. And again, Jim Drizzle has just tied this up in one. Cat, you got to let me move forward. You're not the commentator, bro. Love my cat. I really do. Oh, God, you're going to fall, bro. Jesus. Anyway, so we got round number three just about to begin. Jim Drizzle just won the last one by taking out Shale first, so taking out Satan. And again, we are tied up at one apiece in this best of three between Wolf21 and Jim Drizzle. Whoever takes out Satan first this time is going to be your overall 2-1 winner and advance on to round number two. If Jim Drizzle wins, he's going to face iCasper next week. If Wolf wins, he faces Slackaholicus next week. So it's all dependent on who wins as far as the matchups here for the remainder of the playoffs. But we're off and racing. Best of luck to both of you two. And just like that, we got a banned item Ipecac on the left side for Wolf. So he's going to restart, but a very good find with growth hormones for Jim Drizzle. So he's got himself damage up and movement speed increase. Again, if you guys don't know the rules, Cat, you have to move. Sorry, I love you, but come on. Come on. Dude, you can't sit like this. Thank you. That's not gravity, bro. That's stupid. There's a huge difference. Gravity is not my cat's friend, and he doesn't realize it. Anyways, like I was saying, really good starting item again. Sorry, you just moved your head into my hand, dip. So we got Max's head now for huge damage up and knockback on Wolf's tier, so we're both looking nice here. Again, both taking out boss fights. Again, more damage up with that with that small rock in Wolf's room. He'll take that at the end of this. Not going to do it right now, as he doesn't want to take any damage, but we'll see which of the two Steven items he also gets. Again, Hierophant card, about two soul hearts there. And again, let me list out the rules one more time. You saw Jim actually taking those random pills. That's because they were unidentified, and he forces those to be taken here. So if you look at the two imager links, those will give you all of Jim's breakdowns for the rules here. Much like, see, Wolf walking into a challenge room has to take that item now because that's passive health up, so has to take it and go through this challenge room. A little bit more damage on his tears. And again, also with Little Steve following him around, he's going to shoot out those homing tears from behind him. But lots and lots of damage on those tears thanks to that small rock for damage up, fire rate increase, and he's moving slightly slower with it. My God, so many people. Captain Planet, thank you. Jesus. And there was somebody I didn't call out by name as Eureka, I think it was. But I didn't call you out by actual voice, so thank you as well. Holy, and Scarboroughs, holy crap, thank you too. I just noticed that. That's a new one too, so thank you all. Holy crap. And you guys, you should know me all well enough. I turned that back off later too, so seriously, thank you very much. Totally unnecessary what you're doing. Thank you. I will just say that again. Thank you. Because you're making me actually able to eat, so thank you. See, a little bit of range up there. We got Harlequin Baby as well for Jim Drizzle. Excuse me, and you see that follower is following around shooting out those V-pattern red tears. He's on down to his caves, has caves 1 and caves 2 together in an XL4 himself right now. So again, Wolf, after just getting through his item room here, is going to wind up, I was going to say, looking for his boss fight, but well, the long search has ended. It took so long to come across this. Yeah, it's all good, just don't eat, you're fine. Hey, the cat eats better than I do, I'll be the first to admit it. So let's see, Wolf moving into his boss fight, going to take on Monstro to finish off his basement. And again, we see the damage differential. Yeah, Jim's got some damage up, but Wolf is really rocking some damage. See what I did? Rock, small rock in his head. Puns. Anyways, more fire rate increase with Squeezy, two more soul hearts for Wolf, and he's on down to the caves. In which we got a normal, well, not normal caves one, we got a catacombs, the expansion version of it, but a regular one of two floors happening here. And again, Jim has to take this. Totally useless, though. Charm of the Vampire, every 13 kills, gonna give you a half a red heart heal. Yeah, you're the blue baby, that doesn't happen. But again, Kane's Eye, for about the seventh time this evening, has shown up. And again, 25% chance as you go onto a new floor that gives you a full compass reveal. Jesus, funky fish. Holy crap, guys, you're making me not be able to catch up to this. Thank you, man. Or assuming man, but you get the human. How about that? Thank you, human. Huh. Can talk like the cat. Thank you, human. I appreciate the catnip fun. No, seriously, thank you guys very much. Holy crap. Yeah, possibly human, possibly cat. And let's see, again, Jim gonna have to go through another Blood Challenge room here as he's found health up in this one. So again, another, in this case, not container, but one more blue heart in place of that red heart you would normally get as you're using Blue Baby. So he's gonna have to take out a few extra enemies. In this case, some, I don't want to call them mini-bosses, they're actual legitimate bosses. And I think they have slightly less health, so I guess they are the mini-boss version. Spaz and Hip, actually, I was kind of thinking of a way to do that. I was trying to figure that out. Any info on next season of Boiler? Really good question there by Danny. For anybody that's new too, because I'm sure that's actually been a pretty popular question that I missed a few thousand times tonight, so I apologize. Next season of Boiler, we're going to do In Binding of Isaac Rebirth, which won't be out until sometime the beginning of next year. When we know the release date, we'll start actually figuring out when we're going to do our play-in tournament. Now, okay, here's where it gets kind of confusing, because we don't exactly know how that's going to work yet. But anybody that signs up that meets the requirements, and it's basically just, can you cast on Twitch? Yes. Are you not stupid? Yes. Or depending on how you want to answer that, no. Do you like English? Do you like pancakes? Yeah, whatever. Anyways, Mulligan on Jim's side. He's got a 1 in 6 chance now of firing out. Wait for it. Right about here, probably. There it is. That attack fly is a 1 in 6 chance of spawning it with your tier. And again, really nice damage up off of that, too, though not as often on the firing of it as you may like to think it would be. But what about waffles, Casper? What about waffles? Anyways, where was I with this? So anyways, basically, if you can cast on Twitch and you can keep eyes in the same spot for about 6.5 months on your screen, you're good. So we're going to have a play-in tournament for 20 at least open spots. Anybody in the playoffs gets an automatic invite for next season. So if they want back in, they're back in. Now, again, they don't have to come back by any means, so it's still, there may be more. But there's at least 20 open spots for everybody to play in for, and we'll have public signups again like we did for this season. And again, everybody's going to have a fair shot. Ooh, and those fair shots. About technology laser for Wolf. Uh-oh. This build just keeps getting better and better. How about range up? He doesn't need it, but hey, you have to take it anyways. So more range there on Wolves, but how about that Tech 1 laser firing out with some nice damage increase already? What about crepes? Oui. Je t'aime crepes. Yeah, see, I remember French. Ha ha! I remembered something! I only took 5 years of it in high school, but I actually retained something, guys. Yes. Anyways, we got Jim Drizzle on the right looking for his two boss fights. They gotta be on the right side here. And we got a boss fight to finish off the caves too for Wolf as well, so he's moving on into Face Fistula. Yet another item rock for him, my goodness. Oh my god, Shining, thank you. Again, Duravos, holy crap, thank you. I blink for 2 seconds. I was gonna say, I was pretty sure you had been there before, Shining, but either way, thank you again, because the thank you is still very much meant, so thank you again. Let's see, another Depths 1 normal style here for a Wolf, though. Again, it's not really supposed to be the scary off the bat. That's more Necropolis type of spawn, so I'm a little bit frightened about this level for Wolf. Normal Depths 1, though, for him, and again, he does have the time advantage, as we got Jim moving into 2 back-to-back boss fights. There's Fistula just the same that Wolf just fought. But again, he's got one more right after this to take out his caves. It's actually not a spectral tier on Wolf's side. That's that darkened color on technology is because Wolf has actually got the small rock in his head that you can't see. So that's actually small rock coloring. Wolf doesn't have any spectral, does he? No, he doesn't have any spectral stuff yet. And again, that second of 2 boss fights, we got Green Peep just about over halfway dead here on Jim Drizzle's side. So immediately those 2 eyeballs come out. Usually that happens at about 75% and 25% health left. And you wind up with a lot more jumping, in my opinion. Although I don't think that's technically part of this fight. He tends to jump all the time against me. So it gets very annoying. Very easy boss fight, though, on the left-hand side. We got Monstro 2 for Wolf. 1-2 on the glitches of his head. Wait a little bit in Brimstone. 1-2, wait, Brimstone. 1-2, wait, Brimstone. Move in between that 2 and Brimstone on the wait. Move side to side. You keep him in this pattern here infinitely, and he will never be able to touch you unless he happens to move because he were knocked back. Can't sleep. Clown will leave me. I mean, can't stop watching Boiler. I mean, Clown will leave me. Again, damn you, Simpsons. Wow, both getting loading screen errors, so there's a Necropolis expansion version of Depths 2 here for Wolf. We're waiting out Jim's as he's heading into his Depths himself. Let's see if he doesn't happen across an XL floor. But again, it's all about, there we go, when Flash decides and wants to actually be a bro. So thank you there, buddy. You can do the rest of this now. There we go. So an expansion version of the Necropolis here for Jim Drizzle. Glad to have you back, Darvos. Thank you again, man. Yet being the keyword. Alright, so both this time with some pretty nice looking health builds. It's all a matter of actually keeping those soul hearts, though, because again, you notice those aren't actual containers for anybody new to this. Blue Baby has got irreplaceable soul hearts. You can pick up more later, but again, it doesn't fill containers. They just disappear, as you just saw that half of one disappear off of Wolf's side. And there's that last item room. Again, it doesn't actually show a number, but Wolf is one floor ahead here. So that is a Depths 2 for him. Alright, not about a halo of flies, so two orbitals for that last item on Wolf's side. That'll block some incoming shots. Doesn't really damage much with those. There's a few enemies those will hit, but not very many. More pills on Wolf's side, and again, if they're unidentified, because of the rules, you have to take them right away. So in this case, range up for Wolf. Ken doesn't need it. That technology one is capped out range anyways. We'll grab some more money out of that secret room. And keep on moving over to the left here. About a boss fight somewhere along this room. Look at this, it's almost a blue laser now for Wolf. That's how much range up he's gotten. That laser has almost become blue. I call it blue-gray at the moment, but that is almost blue. Oh, how about more range? Let's make it even more blue. Heck yeah. Holy crap, Echo, thank you. Jesus, guys, I can't even keep up with this anymore. This is getting ridiculous. Oh, thank you very much, Echo. Seriously, thank you. So let's see, fire rate increase there for Jim. Excuse me, that wasn't even fire rate. That's actually shot speed, if I'm not mistaken. Wasn't that Magic 8 Ball? No, it wasn't. Ha, I can't even tell. That was fire rate. I can't see what I'm looking at anymore. So let's see, having to replace now. Ugh, man. Well, not having to replace it, but he's going to anyways as Wolf. So he doesn't want to be hanging on to, and I, again, do not blame him, doesn't want to be hanging on to Kamikaze. So actually now can gamble on the run with his portable slot machine. And can gamble in this arcade as well. Ooh, no luck, doesn't get the purple slot machine, so he'll be moving on. Saying hi. Saying hi to Echo. Say hi to all the new subscribers. Say hi to all the new people that pay for your catnip addiction? No? Don't want to talk? What? Okay, now I've confused him. I was trying to get the cat to continue to speak and actually thank everybody to fund his catnip addiction, but I'll speak for him. Thank you for funding the cat's catnip addiction, guys. You have no idea, dude. This cat's a fiend. I'm not even joking. Like, you've seen people, like, you know, like, oh, man, you know, I gotta be on this for the rest of my life, medication-wise. Yeah, the cat considers catnip medication he needs to be on the remainder of his life to somehow survive. It's kind of scary. He's a fiend. And he thinks now that I'm gonna give him catnip because I keep saying the word, so he's over by the fridge waiting for it. Alright, so we got Wolf facing off against Mom's Foot here. Again, down to just the 3.5 hearts. He found some pretty nasty rooms to deal with. And he'll be able to gamble, hopefully be able to find some soul hearts coming out of that if he's at all lucky. But again, just about done with Mom's Foot here. We got same floor on Jim Drizzle's side. There he is. Catnip, funded by all the subscribers. Wow, all these pills. Well, not gonna like this. So luck up on the first one. Oh, thank you. Balls of Steel, 2 soul hearts. Already knows what Bomzer Key are. Might as well turn his tears more blue with that extra range up. He'll hang on to the Bomzer Key for later on. Yeah, maybe that Chariot card instead. Indeed, Chariot card it is. So moving on to his womb, 5.5 hearts. Curse of the Lost. Oh, God. So extra rooms added onto the womb one here. Wow, that's almost become green. I think that laser became green. It's so blue, it's green. Didn't know that was a thing. It ain't easy being green. What's up, Sped? How you doing? And thank you very much. Holy crap, I just realized that you just subscribed. Damn, dude. So many people tonight. Thank you, guys. I can't even keep up with this anymore. Ooh. So many soul hearts. And even better, how about Cancer sitting there for double fire rate? Ooh. This is a tough call for Wolf. There you go. Very, very nice use of that unicorn horn. I like this move here. So Wolf keeps himself invincible, grabs Cancer and those 2 soul hearts without taking any damage, and look at that fire rate on Technology 1. Although, again, quickly catching up. Thank you, more Balls of Steel. More health on Wolf's side now. He's only half a heart less than Jim Drizzle's got. Jim's fighting Red Mom right now to finish off his depths too, and very, very close on Wolf's tail here. Boy, and look at this, Wolf coming across his boss fight, trying to keep that one floor advantage going for him. And with that world card in tow, though, Jim's going to be able to see his entire map layout, whatever floor he utilizes that in. Again, Teratoma on the left, Red Mom dead on the right, another health container, a couple of bombs out of that bomb bag, along with Polaroids, so Jim's going to take that with him. Every time he gets hit, that's a 5-second damage shield. Uh-oh. He's down to the womb, that's a loading screen error, he's got a world card. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. What's gonna happen? Do we get an XL floor, I wonder? Yes, we do. Uh-oh. Curse of the Labyrinth. There's that world card. Jim gonna head straight to 2 back-to-back boss fights. Wolf gonna head down to Womb 2. And he's gotta make quick time now to stay ahead of Jim. So again, there's where that world card comes in exceptionally handy. On XL floors, yeah, you notice no item rooms, no stores. Jim is gonna beeline across to the left here. So even though ranking-wise, this wouldn't be an upset, theoretically, keep in mind, Jim looking to pull an upset, taking out one of last year's finalists here. Wolf looking to continue on and move into round 2 himself with a win. Whoever takes out Satan at the end of Shale first is your winner here at 2-1. Ooh, if only that weren't still banned. So Jim finding the shovel in his secret room, but notice those Moonstrats bombs right on through. That's first floor womb boss fight on the other side of this, and then Mom's heart to take care of. So Wolf gonna move on along. Uh-oh. He's found Mom's heart. Hang on to your butts, guys. This one's gonna get close. Oh, God. We're in technically the same room right now. Oh, boy. So again, Wolf gonna move in. Technically, now he's one floor ahead. Next room evens that entirety out, though. And again, he'll be taking on my... Yeah, there's those butt clenches. I was waiting for the Wolf subscribers to hit it. Butt clench? Get. So here we go. Wolf already over 25% of the way through Mom's heart. Jim gonna pick up his 12th container, health heart, I should say. Move on into his Mom's heart fight. So, oh boy. And again, we race through Shale this time. You have to kill off Satan to be the winner. This is not the end-all be-all, but we are dang neck and neck right now. Wolf with that damage advantage is just about done with this fight. And again, you can thank Cancer and that double fire rate on his Technology 1. He's on down to Shale first. And again, Jim just has to make up some time now. How about Moonstrats for Wolf? He'll hop into his secret room. He only is able to get out the one way, so he's really going to have to hope that that pays off for him. Didn't get too far away from his starting room. But let's see where this goes. Alright, down to just the 4.5 hearts as Wolf as well, so hoping for some soul hearts if he can. Jim in a much better situation health-wise. And again, halfway through Mom's heart, we got a dead end on Wolf's side. He just has to wait for these to get anywhere near in line though, as he pierces right through these masks, doesn't have to worry about these night enemies. And even the champion version here is not that scary. So let's see, might as well gamble a little bit. Wolf hoping for some soul hearts out of it. There we go, now it's getting to his side of the room. more pills. I think he's already had those. No, he hasn't. Unidentifieds. Ooh, and it's health up, so another health container. Thank you. We'll gladly take this. Again, Jim just about done. Still at 12 hearts, has finished off Mom's heart himself. Again, even that God room would just be a way to Shale, and that is where he's headed. So both on Shale, both looking for the devil fight. Whoever kills it first, gonna be your winner. Clench your butts, guys. Oh, dang right. Of all races, this one's definitely worthy of coming right down to the wire like this. And again, they're on a call together. So again, let me get you a link into both Jim and Wolf's channels. Go say good luck to both of these guys. Again, they may not be reading chat, they're kind of focused, but wish them both good luck. It's all about being there for them and giving that support. Whether they know it or not, they'll feel it. Alright, still nothing on either side. Jim dealing with double slots here, so he's got a little bit of a worse room going on. Wolf quickly through this one. Let's see, he's still gambling. Uh-oh, we found our boss fight on Wolf's side. This is where we get to be real fun, guys. Where's Jim's at and how quick can he get there? Because Wolf's got a heck of a build. He's got plenty of bombs for this. The one in the center takes out about half damage on phase number one, and Jim has got to find this boss fight and has got to find it now. Ooh, look at this. So Hermit Card all the way over to the other side of the floor is Jim Drizzle. Let's go down. Oh boy. Still nothing here. God, this scares me. I don't know where he's going to find this, and Wolf is already about halfway through phase number two of the devil fight. So coming down, this is a lot of damage on Wolf's side. He's only got the 2.5 hearts left, and here comes phase three, the trollinest of trolls. So you have to be very careful with, again, these exploding poop socks when they do spawn. If they spawn, where is it? There it is. There's the second one. So now Wolf knows where they are, and he's going to try to stay away from them. Wow, he got too close to that. But again, already just melting through. Again, that technology, double fire rate. He's got damage on it as well with that small rock. And again, melting through. Can almost stay perfectly still. And I think he might have that one safely in hand right now. 1.5 hearts left. He is invincible at the moment, even if you can't see his damage shield. But isn't going to worry about it or take any more hits. One last shot. And ladies and gentlemen, wow. To that race, all of it. But especially to that finish. Wow. To this 2-1 victory, and both of your races in the NFC are upsets in round number one. The number 5 seed and number 6 seed moving on to round two, ladies and gentlemen, as last year's finalist, Wolf 21, a very, very hard-fought victory. And there's that round of applause by Wolf going over to Jim Drizzle, and everybody should do the same thing right now. Seriously, give Jim Drizzle a round of applause. All season, that man has been on point. He's here at 21 minutes and 30 seconds fighting against the Shale boss right now. So again, he was right there with Wolf on all three of these races, not just this one. But again, amazing, amazing job. He was your NFC West champion this season, and again, did an amazing job to get there, as that had Eddie Ruckus and Zero Game Plan and RTC in his division to deal with. So not easy, two of last year's playoff contestants just in that one division. But again, Wolf snuck into the playoffs at the very last second. Yeah, you could see the sigh of relief. Woo! Getting to move on. But again, wow, this sets up rematch weekend. Next weekend, round number two in the NFC looks like this. Double date night number three, confirmed. Casper just said it. We have Wolf 21 versus Slackaholicus, and Mellow Ace versus iCasper, each for the third time this year. Oh man. And there you see, Jim just melted the devil. So if he would have found that boss fight, you can see just how close that would have been. 22 minute, 33 second run for him. But again, that's gonna do it. There you see, Jim, I wanted to make sure he finished it. And there's a round of applause for Wolf. Everybody give Jim Drizzle a big round of applause. That man is not easy to take out. And it took Wolf, one of last year's championship match racers, I should say, to your left, Wolf. Your legitimate left side. I had to think about that. But there you go. See, both of them on there. There's a round of applause by Jim, and again, by Wolf as well. Both of these guys deserve it. Everybody give them a big, big round of applause. That was a hell of a race, guys. That was amazingly, amazingly fun to watch. Congrats to both. Big congrats to Wolf and Mellow Ace, who are both your winners here tonight. So again, next weekend, the NFC, Number 1 seed, Slackaholicus, for the third time this year will take on the number 6 seed, Wolf 21. And the number 2 seed, iCasper, will host the number 5 seed, because I can't do math, Mellow Ace, also for the third time this season. So, wow, be ready for that next weekend, guys. It's going to get crazy up in here. Just hold on to your butts and your hearts, guys. Again, big, big thank you to Jim Drizzle and to Full Metal Gambit this year. I got to say goodbye to both of them, sadly, as they're both out in the first round with upset victories against their rule sets added. So, wow, to this playoff. This is only going to get crazier, guys. I don't have words for how awesome this is so far and how much better this is going to get.